It can be very frustrating when you do an IVF cycle if the embryos don't develop well or they end up having chromosome abnormalities. These problems usually arise from abnormalities from the egg, but can also come from the sperm, though less commonly. Recently, there have been some studies which suggested that damage to the DNA in sperm might be a cause for poor embryo development, and that selection of the highest quality sperm during IVF may be helpful. But is it helpful? Or does it just cost you more? Stay tuned. First, a little background. Sperm are really just transport vehicles to get the DNA from a man into the egg. From the time sperm are first made until they meet up with an egg and fertilize it can take several months. During this time, the DNA inside of sperm can become damaged or fragmented. This has been a concern of fertility doctors for a long time. There are a number of tests to look for sperm DNA fragmentation. I did a deep dive on sperm DNA fragmentation testing a few years ago in this video. The bottom line was that these tests are not accurate enough to help identify couples who are at higher risk for problems like infertility or miscarriage. Let's assume for a moment that what I said in that video was wrong. If that were true, then methods to select the best quality sperm with the least DNA damage might produce better embryos. One technique for selecting sperm with low levels of DNA fragmentation is called microfluidics. Basically, it selects sperm that are able to swim through very tiny channels. In a few small studies using microfluidics, there appears to be an improvement in embryo development. However, there is a problem with these studies. Let's say you want to compare two separate groups of IVF patients. One group has standard sperm preparation, and the other group uses microfluidics to try to get the best sperm. In order to show that one group is better, both groups should be as similar as possible. This is a difficult study to do. Recently, researchers did a study which gets around this problem. They looked at over 100 couples undergoing IVF, and they split the available eggs from each couple into two groups, and then compared the two methods of selecting sperm. This is a clever way to get around the problem when comparing groups, since each couple serves as their own control group. Ultimately, they had about 1,400 mature eggs, which were split into two groups of about 700. What did they find? The fertilization rate was slightly better in the eggs that had sperm selected by microfluidics. That, unfortunately, was the only difference they could find. For example, this method of sperm selection did not improve the development of embryos. Both methods produced a similar percentage of embryos that became nice-looking blastocysts under the microscope. What about chromosome abnormalities? It was the same. The percentage of embryos with chromosome abnormalities was similar with both methods. But what if there were more subtle problems with the embryo DNA that was not obvious when they looked at the embryos or tested them? Well, in this study, they also transferred embryos from both methods. They could not identify any difference in the pregnancy rates or early or later miscarriage rates. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: sperm DNA fragmentation testing is not a helpful test of male fertility potential. Microfluidic sperm selection has not yet been shown to improve the embryos you make during IVF. However, there did not appear to be any harm either. Currently, microfluidic sperm selection is a lot more costly than simpler methods. Until the prices come down or studies show a clear benefit to using it, it's probably not worth it. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.